I'm gonna give this a try. I'm gonna take off. Got the cheap $5 control stick here that's falling apart, but a good one's buried. I can't find it right now. Anyway, I'm gonna try to fly this from Willow Run to that that one little tiny helipad in Ann Arbor, north of the airport at the U of M Hospital. This is gonna be kind of a long video because, I mean, you can fast forward to the good parts or whatever. But I'm actually gonna try to use the cheesy air traffic control that's in here. It's really, really bad, but I'm gonna play around with it while we're going. So this is the machine we're gonna fly. And I know Mickey could use, was looking for some help getting it started up and all that. So I'll switch views. This microphone's not the greatest. Switch views into the helicopter. Like such. So this thing's pretty simple. It's got computer controlled startup and all that, so it does everything for you. You don't have to manually abort if you're getting a hot start, all that kind of thing. So first step, turn the battery switch on. Let those boot up. And we'll start each engine one at a time. Let them stabilize. Auto idle. Doesn't look like it's gonna hot start, so we'll start the other one. Are you bored yet? Are you bored yet? Gotta wait for the motors, the turbines to stabilize before you can fly-alize. Alright, we're in good shape there. And Mick, you'll need this. The next step is to engage the FedEx controller. Once you do that, you can fly it. You can fly. We're all clear here for taxi, just about. What do we got here? This will take me a minute to figure out what I want to do here. So we'll head out north. Be the quickest. Do I need a piece of paper or what? I'll pretend I heard it.
Taxiing, hold short runway 23 left via taxiway Charlie Delta cross runway 27 Bravo Echo Charlie.
Charlie Delta. Hold short cross 23 left. All right, crossing 27.
Taxi to General Aviation parking via taxiway cross runway 5 left Echo Alpha Flexjet 352.
All right, so I know what runway we're going to. I don't exactly understand how we're going to cross 27. It's kind of confusing, but taxiway Charlie, then Delta. We're going to hold short of whatever runway we bump into. Lift it off the skids there. A little fast. Don't want to go that fast, but I guess we are. I have enough hard disk space to record this video. They said 2-3 left via Charlie and Delta. This looks like we're on Charlie. We're gonna turn on Delta. We're gonna cross 27. Okay. I guess we're getting on Delta, but I don't think this crosses a runway. Let's try something different. See what this does. Much like a runway, does it? That makes very little sense. Can we get a better look? Oh. Entered the taxiway here. Maybe this is Delta. Charlie, I mean. This is some weird taxiway edge stuff here. That was some huge runway safety area. Oh, this looks better. It's actually our runway, but we didn't quite get to it the right way. Try that. That should work.
Willow Run Tower Delta, Hotel Bravo Echo Charlie ready at runway 23 left north departure.
Delta, Hotel Bravo Echo Charlie cleared for takeoff runway 23 left departure to the north approved.
Cleared for takeoff runway 23 left Bravo Echo Charlie.
We're good to go there. here a couple minutes ago, so I know it's a left traffic pattern, but I didn't seem to say much about it. So this is going to be kind of a long flight over to,
Bravo Echo Charlie, continue for north departure. I will contact you next when you leave my airspace.
Willow Run Tower Delta, Hotel Bravo Echo Charlie, continue for north departure.
Get some airspeed here. Alright, so now we're finally on our way to Ann Arbor. Nobody noticed the red on the engine there, did ya? I fixed it, but we were over-torqued there a little bit. So there's St. Joe Hospital, I think, coming up on the right. Do a little bit of flyby on St. Joe. head over the Huron River over there and make our way into North Ann Arbor. This thing flies really weird. It feels like it's in a huge crosswind. And the water treatment plant. Head right over 23 here. That's northbound, and there's southbound on the other side, I think. Well, it's north and south. I don't know what the other road was. Video's a little jerky between this being an old video card and doing all the video capture stuff. This time I know where the helipad is ahead of time, which should make this easier. The video's a little jerky. So we are coming up on it here pretty quick. I'm going to go for the little helipad this time. Last time it was the big one. I'm going to try the little smaller one. I do have the view here this time on the stick, so I can look around a little bit better. That's the big one right there on the left. The little one's coming up here a little bit down the road there, just a little bit there. You can see it also on the left. Not sure what the best way to come into this is. Video's getting real jerky. So that should be right in front of us up there. Scrape our butt on the trees a little bit. Way too much airspeed. There it is right there. Not sure quite what the best way to come into that is. Conveniently close to the road, which is inconvenient for the approach. bet you can't see through the panel, eh? The panel's kind of in the way. This looks like a royal pain in the ass without flying over the road.
Generic 77 Sierra clear to land runway 24. Wing 24720.
Clear to land runway 24 generic 77 Sierra.
Might be more trees here than in real life too. Sure they have a cut path to get to it. I'm doing what I didn't want to do. I didn't want to fly over the road to do it. These trees are kind of stupid. Yeah, I'm doing exactly what I did not want to do. That's sitting there hovering over the road. So be it. Not much of a helipad, is it? Might be the old one in real life and the other one replaced it, I don't know. Let's see. So maybe that might be a lot nicer approach right there, coming into this next time. So let's give that a try really quick. Kinda. Just kinda come out here, swing around, and come back down in at an angle through there. Might be the best way to do this. The darn thing now. Yeah, I lost orientation pretty bad there. Try that again. Not see it coming back around. I figured off the corner of this building here, kind of coming in on an angle. Try that again, see if you can see it from way back here. Well, there's one on top, too. We'll have to try that later. Why does that look... I am disoriented as heck. I thought you'd come around the corner of this building and just set right down into it. It sure looks that way coming out. Yeah, I don't even see it coming back this way. Unless it's this other corner I'm thinking of. Maybe this is the building. No, it's not lining up at all. Yeah, what a pain. Once again, no idea where it is. Not look anything like it did before. I'm probably somewhere completely different thinking I'm where I was. Yeah, this spot will take some practice for sure. I think we're just on the wrong building here. We'll do a touch and go on this and then try it one more time. I lost my little bit of forward speed I had there. Back to where is that thing? It's right there. Just me really losing track. Probably the best way to do it is just to come around here and kind of plop in with it in front of you. And I need to work on this visibility stuff. This is a much better way to approach this helipad. There we go. Hope you enjoyed the video. My hands are sore now. Have a good one.